Hey guys, welcome back to another walkthrough. Today we're going to be doing more chapter 6 of GNN. In the last episode, we went on tour of the studio while we waited for Mako to bring the video of Charizard going berserk. And then we just saw Karina performing, I think. No, but then we saw Karina's appearance. And then I think Olga and Max got in an argument, so... Where are they? See over the left side. Oh, there they are. Hey, nice job out there, Olga. You all got that rapier wits of yours. Hold on. What do you say? What do you mean by that? Are you saying I'm not nice? What? No, I just... Maybe you should start by taking your job more seriously yourself. Come on, Brogly dear. Meow. Who, man? She's got a temper. Huh? It's Olga's voice. His voice impressions are really amazing. It has the same tempo and everything. Right? There's no secret trick or... I've got it. Huh? Got it? What? Shoutout is responding to Max's signals. Tim, try stomping your foot down. Like this?
Get out of my way!
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought. You noticed Max set his foot down earlier too, right? That was his cue to have Chatot mimic Olga. Oh, I get it. He sent signals like that to Chatot to have it mimic the voices he wanted. Well, guess I'm found out. You're pretty good. Are there any other signals to use? Well, yeah, but I'm not going to give them all away. Where's the fun in that? I think I'll head back to my dressing room now. Well, he's going very slowly. I think in next rehearsal's right to start. Let's go ask Hiro. How are the checks coming along, sub-control? They're done. No problems. Great, let's move on to the next rehearsal then. Are you ready, Tim? Yes. Great, let's say hoot hoot ready for the signal. 3, 2, 1, hoot hoot.
Oh. Karina!
Thank you.
Your music is so beautiful.
It really was.
Backstage, she's humble and modest, but when she performs, she's proud and confident. That duality makes me breathless.
Not the performance?
Hear me now. I declare that one day she and I will perform on stage together.
I can't believe this. What's next?
That was beautiful, Karina. Thank you very much. Just do the same thing for the real deal. Alright, it's about time we should call on Olga and Max. Oh, I can go let them know we're ready. Great, thanks. What shall I do in the meantime? Oh, right. Could you go put your violin backstage for now? Of course. That was a great performance. I can't wait to see the reactions we get from our viewers. To be honest, I was worried at first, but I guess it didn't need to be. No wonder she's a rising star among violinists. She definitely lives up to her reputation. Right, doesn't she? Ha 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 ha. Why are you acting so full of yourself? When is the next scene you're going to rehearse? Oh, a scene where the assistant Pokemon gives Karina her violin. Keith went off to fetch the Pokemon, but he hasn't come back yet. I wonder where Keith has gone to. Could that be that he was cornered by Olga again? Hero. Oh hey Karina, did you put your violin back there? Yes. Thanks. Now once Keith gets back, let's start our next rehearsal. Hero, this is bad.
The assistant Pokemon won't make it? What are you saying, Keith? So sorry. I mixed up the dates of our schedule. Oh, my head hurts. I need a Pokemon. Any Pokemon to help us out. Hey, I know. Tim, do you think Pikachu could fill in for the day?
My Pikachu?
Mm-hmm. He seems to enjoy music. I think he'd be great.
All right, if you really think he could help.
I can't. You're really saving my life. Thank you. Mine too, thank you. Okay, I'll need Pikachu to push the cart with the violin. Right over there, to that spot with the mark on it. That's right. And Tim, would you mind standing over there for me?
Sure.
That's where Karina will receive her violin.
You're a big help. Thank you so much.
I'll be
too. All right, let's start rehearsal. Yanma, move those cameras exactly as you would for a real shoot.
Yan-yan!
Pikachu, you ready?
I've never been more ready. I've got this. Here's the spot.
So she picks it up here.
Oh!
Watch out!
The violin. Oh my god, the violin. It's smashed.
Yeah, I'm okay.
It's broken. Oh my god, the violin. Oh,
my precious violin.
This is bad.
Last.
I was standing right there, and I couldn't do anything.
Oh no. I'm so sorry. Yama and Nara made a mistake like this before. We need to stop shooting for now. Keith, take Karina back to her dressing room. Of course. Come with me, Miss Mitchell. This way. You'll take the pieces of the violin? Right. Here, let me help you pick them up. What could have gotten into the Yama? They've never messed up their instructions like that before. Yang Yang. What are they saying, Pikachu? They say it's not their fault. Huh? What do they mean? We should talk to them a bit. Oh, a new case. Investigate the violin situation.
Everyone thinks the Yanma made a mistake and caused the accident. But is that really true? Let's go see what the Yanma have to say.
Nyan Nyan. That was a pretty heavy collision. If you're still feeling dizzy, just take it easy. You told us earlier, Dad, that there was no way you messed up your instructions, right? It says they followed their instructions to the words, and it says that if we look properly, we should be able to prove it. Nyan Nyan. They said they moved exactly as the staff told them to. Really? Maybe there was a mistake in the instructions themselves then. Well.
Hey, Dad.
I think we got what we can from Yanma. Hero seems to think the accident happened because Yama messed up, but Yama said they followed their instructions. Yeah, let's try and find out what really caused the accident. We should talk to the staff members next.
Any news?
No, I'm just gonna skip. I want to skip this part because I just want to see if they will ask. I was looking at the script when it happened. Okay, there's a script. Oops. Okay, we have the script. Oh, the new ladies tell Yanma what their moves are. Oh, the cue sheet. Did we talk to Keith? Oh, never mind. Hero? Pressing back to his signal. Okay, Keith has a cue sheet. Hey Keith, how's Karina doing? She's very upset. She says you need to be alone for a while. I don't blame her. She clearly was attached to that violin. Do you have any idea what an accident like that could happen, Keith? No, he doesn't. Shoot from above, shoot from the right. Move away and follow. Yes, director gave us those in front gave those of us in charge with Yama cameras a cue sheet a few days before it. Able to shoot. We taught Yama how to move the cameras based off that, but I double checked it and I'm positive I got the instructions right. The original key should be in the sub control room. Well, there's Mim. Why is Mim key wandering outside? Oh, wrong. Oh my god. I was checking if I was using the cue sheet, but there was something like odd I couldn't put my finger on. Yeah, I don't even know. Do we... Something's bugging me. Why are you saying that my case list like that, Pikachu? I just have a feeling that the key to solving this mystery about the accident is hidden in the evidence we already gathered. Okay, that's weird, isn't it?
Everyone is thinking that the Yama made a mistake. The Yama say they did what the instructions told them to do. So what caused them to crash into each other?
The cues are coming on the camera, so they're running down. The cues are running down. I think it's this one and one.
That's right. It seems that someone tampered with Yanma's plan in order to cause the collision. The question is, how did the staff not notice something like that? Why would one Yanma have two movement plans? I don't think this was an accident at all. In fact, I think this is a case for us to solve.
Oh, wait. Maybe the Culver had some kind of grudge against Karina. Maybe they had destroyed the violin as revenge for something. Revenge, huh? I thought it wasn't their piece. Okay, we need to talk to Karina first.
Accident. But why? I can't imagine Karina would have enemies, but let's see what she has to say.
Someone's behind this incident. Well, obviously. Karina, please listen calmly. Tim, what's going on? We found out that the accident earlier was actually deliberately caused by someone. What? But how?
Yes.
Is what you said true? Please tell me everything. Someone had given a fake instructions to Yanma? Is that what caused the accident? That's right. But who would do such a thing? Why? It's possible that the culprit had some kind of grudge against you and destroyed the violin as payback. Could you tell us a bit more about your violin? Of course. My grandfather made it for me before he passed away. It's one of its kind. When I get discouraged, I remember the message he left for me on the violin. It makes me feel better. A message? There was some metal on the violin. I never noticed. Oh, you couldn't have. It's written on the inside of the back plate, after all. Oh, so you can't see from the outside? Okay. Let's talk to the cricket too. You'll help us find a culprit? Thanks, we can use your help. We don't know who did this or why, but don't worry, we'll get down to the bottom of things. Apparently, Crickton was present when Karina saw the message too. Crickton says Karina read the message to it. It said, "To my darling Karina, even when I'm no longer with you, I will always love you and your music." It's Karina's violin. It looks like it is, but I don't think anyone's going to repair it, okay? The message on the violin. Something on your mind? I helped Crickton pick up the pieces of the violin after the accident, but I don't think I saw a message anywhere on the back plate. Could be that you didn't notice it. If it bothers you, we could double check. Here's Karina's violin. Here's Karina's violin. It really is wrecked, isn't it? Why didn't you get any message to bring anywhere? Oh, so this one is a fake. Oh, a new case. Expose the culprit who did it.
Thank goodness the violins have been swapped. That means that the real one is still safe. That's the one good thing about all of this.
First thing first, we should go to our cleaning club soon. Okay. Karina, the violin there is a fake. The culprit arranged for the accident to happen so that nobody will notice the theft. But then where is the real violin? The culprit probably still has it, but please keep it a secret. We don't want the culprit to get nervous and hide it away. I never noticed that my violin had been swapped with a fake. Well, I think I used my one. The one I used for my performance was the real one. I could tell from the tone. Oh, something falls off to you too? I see. The material seems softer than normal. It must have been difficult for the culprit to get the exact same materials to use. The testimonies you got from the two of them are shedding light on the crime. Let's organise what we know. To get started, let's figure out when exactly the filing swapped. Open your case now.
Already fake.
When was it a fake? Well, when Pixie was carrying it.
True. By the time I had delivered the violin, it had already been swapped out with the fake one. Now we know when the violin was swapped out with the fake one. But we still need to figure out when was the last time the real violin was seen.
During the performance.
Now why do you think that?
Because Karina said that the tone is the real thing.
So, Karina was using the real violin during her performance. She and Crickatoon both confirmed it to be true. And that means the culprit swapped out the violin after Karina finished her performance, but before I moved it.
They switched out backstage, okay. So the culprit is someone that works here.
Yes.
I don't think it's Karina. That's her alibi. After my performance, I went backstage to put my violin there. Did you see anyone else around backstage? I don't remember. I'm sorry. Because why would she do that to her own violin? Let's go ask the others what their one is.
What?
No. So we think us playing detective is fun and games. Yeah, I figure I'd go over my script one more time in my dressing while I waited. Did anyone come by during that time? Oh yeah, a staff member came by to call me. I was in the middle of something, so I couldn't open the door. But I said I'd be right out. Well, maybe, was that Amelia? Because she said she could let them know that they were ready.
So, let's gather information.
Excuse me. Hey, what's wrong? Well, it seems... Well, about Jackson, that just happened. It seems like it was deliberately caused by someone. What? But then who's the culprit? We're investigating that now. That's why... I don't know what it says. We're here the whole time. Yes, we keep an eye on the studio from here. I think it would have been difficult for the people here in the sub-control room to swap out the violin. Wait, was that Mimikyu or whatever you pronounce his name? Mimikyu? You again. What do you want now? Oh, come on. You're a detective. Don't let her intimidate you. Go on. Ask what you need to ask. Where were you after we finished the first rehearsal? I stayed in my dressing room. I was given probably a nice brushing. Did anyone stop by during that time? One of the staff members came by to call me. I answered, although I didn't open the door. I see. Someone comes all the way to get you, then the least you could do was open the door for them. Although, come to think of it, something odd happened after that.
Keep gathering testimony.
What was this strange occurrence? Someone came and beat on the door. I looked through the fogged glass window, but I didn't see anyone there. I wonder what that was all about. Wait, was that Mimikyu that beat on the door? Maybe, it could have been. Amelia.
What's the matter?
Are you still looking into the accident, Tim? Huh? Oh, don't mention the swap by Lynn until we're ready to catch the culprit. Oh, yes. You mean after Karina played? I was checking the dressing rooms to call on Max and Olga. We didn't come back to the studio alone, didn't you? Weren't you able to find them? Oh no, not exactly. They both seemed like they were busy, so I just told them what I needed through the door. Oh, I see. Did you meet anyone else? Well, oh, I remember. I ran into Keith near the studio. Okay. Okay, so does that rule Amelia out of this? I went to Olga's dressing room from the studio. I knocked on the door and she said, and she responded, "Thank you, I'll be right there through the door." I went to Max after our chat called on Olga. I knocked on the door and told him you're ready, and he said, "Gotcha, I'll be right out through the door." Do you think you'll be able to get back filming? I say the odds are 50-50. I already put in a request for a new violin. I feel bad for Karina, so let's have to use a new one. I was in the studio ever since Karina finished her performance. I was making sure the staff knew the plan for the show, checking the pushes and so on. Seemed like Sierra Hero and the staff here had a solid alibi.
Now that I think about it, this person couldn't be the culprit.
Yeah, I think so. Are you investigating the accident? Don't overdo it. Thanks. Where were you during the rehearsal, Keith? I don't think I saw you right until the accident happened. I went down to a lower floor to call the assistant Pokemon as soon as we found Hiroglu. What happened after that? Well, it didn't show up, even when the scheduled time came, so I called the office to check. Turns out I mixed up the dates and had scheduled it for the wrong time. So I ran back to the studio to let Hiro know. So that's what all the ruckus was about. Did you run into anyone on your way back to the studio? Yeah, as I recall, I ran into Amelia. She just finished calling on Max and Olga.
Yes! So the culprit is?
Is?
Wait, what's that? All of our suspects have alibis?
Huh? Oops. Well, this is a conundrum. I didn't expect everyone to have alibis. This can mean only one thing. The culprits created a fake alibi. That's right. The culprit must have used some sorcery to create a fake alibi. Our suspects are the people who were moving around on their own. That's four people. Max, Olga, Keith, and Amelia. You don't think Amelia is... I know how you feel, but it's actually past keeping an objective view of everything. So we use some more information. Do we talk to Amelia? Just let me cue you in here. You were wandering around the dressing rooms during the rehearsal, right? Do you think you just had some more about that time? So you visited the dressing room for Broglie's partner, right? What happened then? Someone came storming, you knocked. I meant that was Broglie. Broglie's too narrow-minded. I'm pretty sure it was a bad move because you were pounding on the door. You should go make it up later. Broglie's partner got mad at you? You mean Ogle's in Max's dressing room? You got yelled at when you knocked on the door. You say you heard, "Get out of my way." Was that really Olga? You ran away as soon as you could. Well, I guess we have no way of knowing what was really going on then. I don't think that was Olga. I think that was Chatot. The culprit used a trick to make us believe he was somewhere else when he was actually backstage. A trick? That's right. Amelia proved an alibi for the culprit, so she can help us figure it out. There's something I'd like you to show me, Amelia. Sure, what do you need? You mentioned that you knocked on the doors for Max and Olga's dressing rooms when you visited them. You think you could show me exactly how? Well, sure, but it's not like I did anything special. I just knocked three times. Any staff member at GNN would do the same. So that's the trick the culprit used. Tim, now's the time to gather everyone in the studio.
I figured out the truth behind the accidents.
What are you saying? That one of us here is the culprit?
Yeah, just what do you mean the truth? We're all friends here. Can't say I appreciate the insinuation.
Come on now. Let's allow Tim to speak his mind. Thank you, Hero. Here it is. I'm not one to mince words. The culprit is...
Amelia. Only joking.
Busting up someone's violin!
Nothing. If the violin really was broken. But it isn't broken. That one was a fake, wasn't it?
A fake violin? Oh, what an imagination. How could you come up with a theory like that?
You tell him, Tim.
Add a message on the inside.
He checked the pieces of the violin, but there wasn't a message on them anywhere. Karina told us that her violin had a message written on it from her grandfather, which means the broken one couldn't be hers.
A written message? I never noticed such a thing on it.
Right. That's because it's written on the inside. It's something only Karina could know, since she watched the violin being made.
Right. As a child, I played at my grandfather's workshop. He inscribed a special message for me, and it was written on the inside.
You see? Now that proves the broken violin must have been a fake.
But where's the real one?
I think Max probably knows.
But no! I haven't done anything! Listen, the whole time the violin was
backstage. I was in my dressing room. How could I be in two places at once?
Oh boy, this is where you take down his alibi.
Shut up. Definitely.
Actually, my guess is it was chat out in the dressing room. You probably used the trick like this.
Gotcha! I'll be right out!
Oh, yes, that's exactly what I heard.
Admit it! Admit it!
Chat out, be quiet!
You just made it seem like you were still in that room. And then you swapped the real violin that was backstage with the fake.
Oh.
You have to admit it! You have to admit it!
I had no choice. My popularity's been sagging. I wasn't sure the show would get picked up again. And if it didn't, I knew I'd be let go. I couldn't pay back my debts. I'd be finished!
Oh, Max. You were wrong. I was going to have you continue as our host.
What? But everything I did.
I'm really sorry, Max. But I'm afraid I'm going to have to call the police.
What a fool he was. In the end, he was the one who didn't believe in his own talent.
Hey, you guys! I found the videos.
Finally. The culprit is Max. And that case closed. Now let's get back on track. New case. Check the video.
Mako's finally back with the video. Let's go to the sub-control room and watch it. Maybe he'll show us some clues.
Check this out.
Let's play the whole thing through.
Charizard's in
Remember,
front. We've got
keep your eyes on
it.
Charizard.
Yeah.
The daytime parade is now starting. Everyone is excited to see the popular Pokemon of the park marching by. Who better to lead than Charizard? We've been told the theme of this
hey,
parade is
look at that
theme.
Balloon! Charizard's eyes turn red.
Aurelia, over here!
Arms used after eye.
Why is this happening?
This is terrible.
I don't know, but it's a great scoop. This is too dangerous. We need to get out of here.
You're right. We have no choice.
That's the whole video.
Exactly how we heard it from the Pokemon at Vine Park.
Yeah.
Did you find out anything?
There was something I noticed.
Right, the scene with the balloon. Right there.
Better to leave than Charizard. We've been told the theme of this year's parade.
Popped. Maybe it had R inside. Tim, zoom in on the balloon and then play it backwards in slow motion.
Okay.
It looks like a needle or something flew at the balloon.
You're right.
Where did it come from? Rewind it a little more.
Yeah, I'll be sure I'm here. I'll put an office up really fast. But he's in here. Get it over your back. Get her on the last city every back in.
Stop there.
Hey, that's Skorupi. And that man.
Oh, wait, wait, wait.
Right.
Oh my god.
Pokemon
that's Keith.
Told us
oh my god, it's Keith.
What's after Harry?
You know, that looks almost like it could be
Keith.
Us. I don't think he was even working at GNN back then.
Mako's right. He only joined us about 6 months ago.
So, it was Keith who caused the incident? He's the one who went after my dad?
Looks like it. And he was hiding in plain sight. Let's go capture Keith.
Okay, let's go capture him. Who would have thought Keith was the culprit? Yeah, he fooled us all. It's even possible that he knew about Max's plan and used it to try to take you out. Me? Think about what he said about... Think back to when the violin got busted. Why did he end up helping in the first place? Well, because Keith had made a mistake about scheduling this system Pokemon and... Oh, that's right. And there was another suspicious point about his behavior. Do you know what that was? Shopping went to said. I'm glad you remember. Keith told you where to stand when I was going to bring out the violin. You must have known that's where the camera would fall. Do you think Keith and Max were working together? Not impossible. We can't rule it out straight away. Why would Keith... No, now isn't time to be asking questions. We need to catch Keith. Let's go, Pikachu. I hope we do catch Keith. But I don't think we will. There he is. Bass, where'd he go? Pikachu, look. Top floor. The roof. Let's go.
Stop, Keith! You can't get away!
We'll just have to see about that now, won't we? Scroopy, keep them busy!
Scroopy. Super skillful sniper.
You missed. Well, help is on its way.
Oh, Noivern, marvelous ultrasonic waves. Oh, the bucket. Oh.
What was that?
It made a camera noise. Does that mean it's a camera? Oh, of course, damn it. If I splash it. Oh my god. Must be a camera then. Yeah. No, please. We need to get you, please. No, please. Go catch him. Hold on to him, please. Please, no. No.
Blast. Got away.
All that work for nothing.
Nope. It wasn't for nothing, Tim. Look at this.
The locket.
That's right. Not just any old locket. It has a little secret.
Yeah, it's a camera, isn't it? Yeah, we did. He did. I'm sure we'll catch him soon. Keith got away, but we got some clues. Okay. That's the chapter over, which was a pretty interesting one. It didn't really add anything really to the story until the end. We just found out that Keith was the one that caused the incident at Pine Park, and he went after Harry, but he got away, but I'm sure we'll catch him. So we're on chapter 7 now. Rhyme Wharf. I wonder what a wharf is. I'll look it up. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I think I'll be back tomorrow for a new Detective Pikachu video. And we'll investigate Rhyme Wharf and hopefully find more clues about Harry and hopefully try to stop Keith. Alright, see you later. Bye.